Most of my adult life has been spent touring Ontario with my outdoor summer theater company, Driftwood. But in 2020, all of that changed.
Even if you create an isolation, you need to show someone. Without that, when it was shut down, the lifeblood stopped.
After 2 years of no shows and no travel, I decided it was time to hit the road.
There's nothing quite like the energetic exchange between, you know, performer and audience.
I think it's just laughter. And with Driftwood, there was a lot of laughter. Unplanned, spontaneous laughter on stage, or from the audience, or sometimes from us.
Join me as I head out on my bike to reconnect with the people and places that I've come to love over the past 25 years. Along the way, we'll visit some of my favorite performance sites, meet with local business owners, and talk to some of the artists who've shared the road with me. Oh, and of course there'll be a little Shakespeare, because he and I go way back. Welcome to day two of the Motorcycle Monologues. I am so excited today. I was actually hoping that these would get here yesterday, but they didn't. And this makes it official. Our very own Motorcycle Monologues swag. Let's check it out. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. So, today, we are going to a beautiful oasis in the heart of urban Mississauga, a city that Driftwood's been visiting since 1999. One of the great perks of being on tour every year is you get to experience all the sweet, sweet treats that Ontario has to offer. We are going to hit up a few bakeries on the hunt for some quintessential Canadian treats. Join me for the Butter Tart Challenge.
One specific summer that I remember was summer I was doing Twelfth Night. Myself and two other actors decided to bike to the Bradley House Museum in Mississauga. And we were so sweaty and it was so far. And we got to the show, we were exhausted from being way too ambitious with our bike ride. It lent itself to a real sense of like release and exhilaration doing the show, and we were really proud of ourselves for having not gotten lost and getting there. A perfect Driftwood day of like doing a show, but also celebrating being with people you love to work with and all of the fun that surrounded that.
My route for today is Mississauga Road. A quaint long stretch running from the bottom of Mississauga all the way to Kate's Town Talk Bakery in the charming community of Streetsville.
Raised in Streetsville, actually. My parents still live down the street. I had been working for Blockbuster. Do you remember?
I remember Blockbuster.
So I was working in their head office. My cousin said, hey, the owners of Town Talk Bakery and Fine Pastry are retiring and we think you should buy it. And I thought about it for, you know, a minute and a half. And I thought, why not? So 11 years ago, February, I opened Kate's Town Talk Bakery. And the butter tart recipe is actually my Grandma Doris's. I have a bunch of handwritten recipes from grandmas and great grandmas and stuff.
Baking, which for a long time, from like most of your early adult life, was probably a thing that helped you to relax, or it was the thing that you did when you weren't working.
Right, exactly.
So has that been replaced?
I don't bake for pleasure anymore. People still, whenever I go anywhere, I'm expected to show up with butter tarts, essentially.
What is it about Streetsville that makes it super unique or super awesome?
Streetsville tries, and I think succeeds, in keeping that small town feel, even though we are in the middle of Mississauga. The tagline is the village in the city. The last year and a half has been, it's been a tricky time, but I think we're stronger coming out of it than we were going into it. What COVID did was really show how important it is to support these small businesses, which make up your city or your town. I know I appreciate going into small businesses and supporting them, and you become a regular to them, and they make an effort to know who you are and know your name.
Sitting down and talking to Kate was fabulous, but now it was time to head back out on the road in our epic quest for more bakeries. One of the reasons I love coming back to Mississauga is the relationship I have with the museums here. A lot of our shows have taken place on the grounds of these beautiful spaces. What is it about Mississauga that's special for you?
Mississauga has changed so much. There is so much more public art. There's so much more awareness of the performing arts. There is a respect for heritage. It inspires you to have so much pride of place so that when I go to places now, I don't say I'm from Toronto. I say I'm from Mississauga. The house that we are in front of, Benares, was built by Edgar Neves, who was in the British military and had Crown land given to him. The house burned to the ground in 1855, but he was able to rebuild on the original foundations. And then from that time, from 1855 all the way up to 1981, lived four generations of Harris family members. So Dora, who is the great-granddaughter of Captain Sayers, lived through the Spanish flu. She was up in one of the bedrooms. We've got a little clipping from a newspaper in Streetsville that talks about, make sure if you're going outside, it's only for something that's necessary. Don't go outside unless you're wearing a mask. Public outings are all canceled. So we've done this before.
And we clearly have made it through, so.
Absolutely. We had a speaker series, and the speaker series was really important to us because a lot of times when talking about Canadians' experience in war, it's told from a very one perspective. The more dynamic and the more diverse the programming, the better we reflect the community that we serve, the more we'll be engaging both online and in person.
One of the great adventures I've had today is making my way around town looking for the perfect butter tart. We've got some tarts from Kate's Town Talk. These four are from La Villa.
La Villa.
La Villa. And then we've got a pair up here from Nova Bakery. And I thought we would do a little butter tart challenge.
We've never met before, Jeremy, but anybody who knows me, who's seeing this, happens to know that butter tarts are my weakness and I'm a total sugarholic.
We're gonna eat them.
Let's go bottom top.
Okay, I think we're gonna try this one. I'll slice it up there. Here, you take that one. I'll take the messy one. Okay. Might even be a raspberry Nutella.
Oh, okay, cheers.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. We're gonna do best crust, best filling, and most innovative.
It's so good. It's so good.
Okay, I'm ready for the next one. A couple choices here. It looks like there's some with nuts, some no nuts. Let's do the nut one.
Oh, this is a runnier. Little.
Lovely.
Yep.
Look at the thickness. Really nice, but untraditional.
Very untraditional.
Innovative.
Some might say innovative. And last but not least. Now this is definitely a gooey. If you like your butter tarts runny,
oh yeah,
this is the one.
Okay.
Good texture.
That's a nice no-nonsense filling.
It's odd to be eating so much in an interview. Normally you're talking in an interview and you're stuffing our faces.
Yeah, we're just stuffing our faces.
I have to say, they're all very kind of newish. I think that we need to introduce a little bit something more heritage-y considering where we are here. Now check this
please,
out.
Please, I'm just gonna put those there.
A traditional butter tart out of a 1911 Canadian cookbook. Go for it.
Let's do it.
These aren't raisins.
No, they're not.
These are currants. So again, very traditional.
Oh my gosh, now that is lovely.
So delicious.
Let's divvy out some awards.
All right then.
Most authentic.
Mm-hmm.
Lindsay's traditional butter tarts. Best crust.
That was a tricky one. I really kind of like Nova's, to be honest. Very light, flaky crust. No heaviness about it at all.
In terms of innovation, right?
Sure.
Kate's.
Absolutely.
Adding a raspberry into a butter tart, that was pretty delish. It was just a nice little hint. And so that leaves us with best filling. La Villa was...
Unquestionably. The thickness of that filling and how much there was in there was fantastic.
Four great butter tarts, four great bakers. Get out there and get some butter tarts.
And come back to the museum.
And go back to the museums.
He that no more must say is listened more than they whom youth and ease have taught to close. More are men's ends marked than their lives before. The setting sun and music at the close, as the last taste of sweets is sweetest last. Writ in remembrance more than things long past.
Well, just as long as you're looking for me. Well, just as long as you're looking for me. Well, just as long as you're looking for me.
What is the connection between Shakespeare and motorcycles?
Oh dear. Shakespeare was a bit of a rebel in his time, right? And motorcycles have that rebellious.
The rebellious, tone, yep. They called him the upstart crow.
Probably didn't ride a motorcycle. But no. If they were around, he probably would have.
I think he probably would have.
I think so.